Hello, I'm Jason Grindstaff, and today we're going to talk about statistics. We're going to be discussing measures of central tendency, which isn't always the most fun topic for students, but the way that I explain statistics to students is much like a language, very much like French or Spanish, you know, or German. The more time that you spend with it and the more example problems that you get, the more that more comfortable you become and the more you can use that language. So today we're going to work through a few examples of measures of central tendency. We're going to be working through mean, median, and mode as our measures of central tendency. In another video, we're going to be looking at variability, and yet another video, we're going to take a look at some confidence intervals. So let's work with an example problem for our measures of central tendency. Here we have an example of college graduates who we have a sample of five students who have rated their college or university, their satisfaction with the college or university on a scale from 1 to 5, 1 being I hated their experience and 1 they absolutely loved it. So here we have sample data of 5 students. What I would recommend, especially if we're doing this by hand, one of the first things that I like to do is I like to reorder the data. Reorder it from lowest to highest or highest to lowest, but in this case, we're going to order our data. So we have 5, 4, 4, 3, and 2. So let's talk about one of our first measures of central tendency, which is mode. Mode is just the most frequently occurring data variable in our data set. So the most frequently occurring, if we just do a visual scan of our data, we can easily see that 4 is the most frequently occurring. So if we have our mode, we've just calculated our first measure of central tendency, and that being our most frequently occurring. Our next, we're going to be looking at the median. And the median is in essence that point in the data set where there's exactly 50% of the data above and 50% below. So in this case, we know that we have five data points. So we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That middle point would be 4. So it's our third point in there. And so we get a median of 4. So if it is 4, we have exactly 50% above and exactly 50% below. And our last measure of central tendency that we're going to look at is our statistical average, or our mean. So our mean, the formula for mean, what we're going to do is we're just going to get the sum of our x's divided by our n. So in this case, we need to add up 5 + 4 + 4 + 3 + 2. So we get 13, so we get 18. So 18, so our sum of our x's is going to be 18 divided by 5. And let me check my math. And we get 3.6. So that's how we calculate mode, median, and mean. And what we can see here that all three of those values, that the median and the mode and the median are the same, and our mean is a little bit different from those three. So that's our measures of central tendency, those being the three most common. In the next video, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at not necessarily how do we capture those measures of central tendency, but how do we further describe our data from the standpoint of variability. So stick around and come back and we'll take a look at range, variance, and standard deviation.